Hello and welcome back to another episode of Phoenix Point. My name is Syken and today we're continuing the journey of a blind playthrough through legendary difficulty. And I must say, I am impressed of how the difficulty level of the game all of a sudden went from, yep, everything's moderate, to holy shit, we're getting our faces melted by the enemies. And I think part of it has to do just with the enemies upgrading continuously, whilst our weapons apparently are mostly side grades. I do understand better now how to deal with bigger armor, but it's not the armor that is the problem. It's a combination of low-level characters that are utterly overwhelmed by the enemies, combined with just not enough gear to go around and feed everyone with the latest and greatest gear. Maybe I am wanting too much with having three squads that are being deployed in parallel. Maybe I would need to let them sit in the base longer and just like accumulate the experience. We'll figure that out. For now, I think this here is a decent task for us, and we do have eight of our finest characters: Little Green, Andrew, Tyler Triggerfinger, Natalia, Hexer, Inappropriate Murphy, Jim the Hammer, Hewlett, and Asian Cow are in this squad. Finally, by the way, we can get you a proper weapon. And whilst we're at it, I was wondering, should you rather get a different handgun? Because this handgun costs two actions. This handgun does not. And really what I would want is a bit more of this. And Jim is ready as well. Mirror the exact same loadout. Inappropriate Murphy. Yeah, let's use some more ammunition. How much ammo does that hold? Virus damage, bursts of three. Okay, six shots. Yeah, that's fine. That looks okay. And with Haxer, we do have a melee weapon. Ooh, that'll push him over. Good, we got a, in principle, we have a good gun. Oh, we got that laser sniper rifle now, by the way. Sorry, just really quickly need to figure that out. Okay, back. I just wanted to double check that the Prime team has the right equipment. Gave them the laser gun. Andrew Sanders, therefore. Needs a proper melee weapon as well. We have a lot of berserkers. Not sure if that's the best choice against this massive thing. If we have all of the weapons available, what is an efficient weapon in terms of actions versus damage? I'm wondering. Maybe the shotgun. Maybe the shotgun. Because my problem is, are we really going to rush up and melee Zerg it down? Is that the plan? Sounds a bit like a Hail Mary play to me. And we do have, theoretically do have room left over. So may as well just take the highest damage gun that we do have against unarmored targets, because we will remove the armor. And that would be this here, 350 points of damage. Ammo capacity 50. Yeah, easy. So these things here would do 240 points of damage. With this one here, we would be at 700 points, point blank, once that thing is up our face. Which I think will happen. It's not a question if, but rather when. And here we do have bursts of 60 points of damage plus 15 virus. To be honest, Murphy, I'm not sure if for this mission we'll just give you a different gun. Look, the virus weapon, okay. Paralyzed weapon is also fun in games, but I think a good old shotgun will be what's needed. Okay, Natalia Ray looks good. Looks fully equipped. And they do automatically come with shotgun proficiency, so should have given that to Tyler a long time ago. Andrew Sanders. Same deal, where's the shotgun? These weapons here would be 180, 360, that's also not bad. Let's shortly do a comparison here, right? Damage 200 and shreds nicely. The shred is good. The other cannon does have a massive burst. Almost 400 points of damage. Doesn't have the shock value, but does have more overall more damage. So I would say we'll give one of our heavies, Haxor in this case, That weapon. Alright, sorry for taking so long, but we're going up against a pretty sizable foe and I want to make sure that we're well prepared. Good, I finally equipped everyone. You can see quite a few of the berserkers do have weapons that they're not familiar with. And specifically the shotguns, I will put a lot of trust in them. Inappropriate Murphy would have a normal assault rifle as a backup just to deal some more damage that is not virus based. Good. Let's go. Right, we landed. So got a huge area to play with. Rather a melee focused team, so I suggest we're moving over here and then straight up to keep it simple for us. Let's take a look what we're dealing with on this side. Not much yet. Okay.
Advancing.
Moving over. Unfortunately, our melees have lost this group here has lost the frenzied headpiece. That'll be a huge advantage having that again. Alright, Natalia charges as well. I think we're done. Skrilla, why is it so injured? Ooh, is that maybe the Skrilla that we have fought, which could flee? That would be super cool. Yeah, I can see it's the same. Well, it's a fireworm thrower as well. So maybe that was the hive which attacked the base. Which then would explain why the Skriller is injured. That's actually a really cool feature if the game would track that. Lots of tritons. So far, they don't know that we're here. We're not a really good long-range team. Could move a bit closer. Here.
I've got a visual.
Wow, there is yet another one. challenge that I'm seeing is my turn. If we're sitting here and just letting them take shots at us, we won't be very successful.
On my way.
Good. Tyler takes a good position.
Let's blast them.
One of the best. And begins the firefight. Murphy. Helps him. And affects them by with viruses. Still haven't fully figured out what that does, by the way.
I'm here.
I suppose it's damage, but I'm not 100% sure.
I'm going in.
Jim moves up.
I'll be right there.
Here. Let's go.
Tell you what. I'm willing to spend a few points. Oh, I thought I could use quick aim and then Overwatch. A status effect prevents the use of that ability.
Hostile missed. Attack successful.
Well, better than nothing. We got a few shots out of it.
I can make a difference.
What's our move? Moving out. Let's go.
Feel a bit betrayed by the fact that I can't move back.
Moving out.
Good, might as well just move over here for now. And end the turn. Okay, we're done. Potentially going to take a hit. Foreseeable. Unfortunately. Good, now We need to deal with action economy yet again. And with being flanked.
Do we have a plan?
Let's see with the worms first.
All I need is a clear shot.
Number one and two are not a problem anymore. Thing got its armor back, and we need to solve that ASAP. Disabled one of the arms, but this guy does have four arms, so. Really doesn't matter at this point. Did quite a bit of damage.
Let's just get this over with.
And I thought we would have no problem killing them. I was dead wrong. Yeah.
This'll make you feel better.
Moving. All set. Let's get this done.
Can't really hit anyone with that grenade.
Identifying target.
Would like to hit the Skrilla because we do have armor penetration up.
All set.
Another arm is disabled, 20 bleeding, and we're looking at 23 hit points. That's close. Come on.
I was born ready. Receiving.
I don't want to take a full set of shots unnecessarily, and I think if I step in, that'll be exactly that. Grenade would be awesome. We don't have that. I don't want to get injured. I don't want to use
Ready to fire.
His shot unnecessarily. That would be a great hit. Well, before we're doing that, he will heal for 10, and he has 3 hit points left over. Can't shift any hit points.
Ready to roll.
Any action points. Moving to here.
In my sights.
Yeah, can't step around that corner. Wait, we hit him. No, we hit his gun. That is ridiculous.
One more to the list. I was born ready. Identifying target.
Shall I just try to take a shot here? Was hoping it would go through the corals. The answer, unfortunately, is it did not. Okay, we're in decent cover. Correction, we were in decent cover. Luckily, that big fat mama is blocking the way for everyone else as well. Double move. Well, apparently single move because they are frenzied. So it's pretty much now or never. With the exception of these fireworms, because they are ultra deadly. Everything else just needs to die. Everything else needs to fire on that big guy. Now, gotta do this the right way. And the right way is making sure that we, first of all, crack all of the carapace. Here wasn't that difficult.
Gotta focus.
War cry. Effect searching, which is good.
Taking aim.
Ah!
Here I come.
Move over. Shotgun. R75, not perfect, but okay.
Here.
Moves over. That's what I'm talking about. 500 points of damage. The thing is about to go down. Now, it would be cool if our exit would be down here. But unfortunately, we gotta fight through all of the enemies.
I'm here. Let's make this happen.
We would be flanked if we're standing here.
What's the plan?
I'm here.
Not sure if this here is the best place. Could be here. He's dealing a lot of damage. I think this one is the safest. Can't indirectly hurt anyone. But apparently I can see someone. Tell you what, how about we're using that? Much better. Okay, we're infecting them with virus. Funneled through that small corridor here. Maybe that was a blessing in disguise. That at least will keep him safe for now. They are still frenzied, keep in mind, that's what's making them so ultra fast. Ah! Yeah, we're taking a lot of heat, but I think we can get through it. Alright, needed to help a friend. I'm back. Just need to reassess the situation here. Oh, I remember this was quite a difficult spot to be in.
Aiming.
So, that here. That kill him? It should, right? Okay, Triton down. Now, Murphy. Could mind control one of them. That guy is feared, I think. But so is the marksman. Good, Mindfragger gone. And he killed his teammate. One, two. Three. And we gotta deal with the other worm. Appropriate Murphy, moving up. Worm down. Cool. Hits the guy, equipment damaged, equipment destroyed. So apparently he does no longer have his gun. I would still do the war cry, just so that this guy is no longer happy.
It's hard to shoot like this. Whatever happens, I mustn't blink.
Okay, Tyler still has his full turn.
I'm on my way.
Moves up.
Taking aim.
And hits this guy. Fantastic. That worked really well. Nope, not yet. Well, we are finished. Yep, we're finished. wondering if I should go to that other zone. I mean, yes, we would be bombarded with a lot of little worms here and there, but that's about it. I think that this is a bit over the top to get a worm, but I do have a plan, and my plan is put these guys on fire. Very much release mind control so that he's now an enemy. We move up, we use the free inventory management of Tyler. There you go.
All set.
Tyler also can freely reload.
By five. I'm going.
These two guys are still a problem.
Standing by. I can do this.
But one that we can solve. I just need to find. The right angle.
Attempting overwatch.
Moving out.
Moves to here. Same trick.
Keep it together, operative.
Jim uses a medkit. Murphy moves over. It hits everyone with a panic, hopefully. 0.000. Okay.
Ready, sort of.
Deal with the worm as well. Still trying to figure out how we do it. Can't really push in there. Maybe the name of the game is to stay here for one more round.
trying to reposition.
Could move to here. Over, we can definitely take their action points. Okay, Warcry was very successful. Takes cover. Good.
Here I come. Dispatch eliminated permanently.
Good. Now they start to panic because we have killed another one of theirs. Good, and if we're starting to
move
over here, we should be okay as well. One of them is panicked, the other one can't really do much, and I'll just use the time. Oh, we can't reload. We have no more ammunition, we do have two more shots. Okay, good to know. Well, everybody has moved.
What the?
We need to kill both of these guys here. Yep, and now we're panicking as well. Not the best time to do that, shall I say. Dare I to say, it's not the best time for that. One. He's dazed. And two.
I'm here.
Keep it together, operative.
One. Not
there.
Two. Not two. Two. One. Two. Okay, so we need to spend quite some time just to do the bare minimum and kill the worms plus a few of the enemies. Now, that's a solid miss. Not good.
What are we doing?
think I got in some damage.
That's out of ammunition now. Great.
All set.
Dashing over. One. Moving over twice.
Ready to fire.
Heavy damage, maybe a kill, not sure.
Hope I don't miss.
She can't free reload, that's the problem. But it's still more effective to use the gun. Disabled arm. This guy is bleeding for 20 and is not dying. Good. Now he's dying. Talia, on the other hand, will need to overwatch. And we've yet again used all of our turns. Oh no, a siren. Well, those were a couple of good hits. Okay, we do have a problem. Mainly that the enemies are continuing to come. Good. I need that for the war shout.
Ready, sort of.
Murphy moves over and heals. Okay.
On my way.
Running.
Jim needs to get out of the way.
Let me take a look.
Healing, and I help him to get his pistol, his shotgun back into action. And then, I mean, frankly, we need to get over to there. I wish that there would be an exit here.
Here we go.
Thank you. need to regain points, and yep, we're seeing more enemies coming in. Fantastic. We got a siren on their way.
I'm here. Let's show them what
we can
do.
Sure, we'll figure something out.
All set.
Move to here.
Holding position.
Don't get too close to the wall, that's all. Because then she can't also mind control us. There for the shouts if needed.
I'm going.
Tyler takes cover and overwatches.
Providing overwatch.
No time to waste.
Asian begins to move away. Appropriate Murphy wouldn't see anyone. In order to be really successful, we need willpower though. But everyone is moving in this direction. Which leaves us with Jim standing in the semi-open. Not great, but at least we got some overwatch. Good shit. Very nice hit.
How does that feel?
Okay, well, that overwatch trap worked well with the siren. The chiron moving into the mind fog again worked good as well.
Oh no!
That is really bad because Tyler very much needed his arms in order to be useful. He will now need some sort of
5x5.
Some sort of support in order to pull, in order to be pulling his weight.
Repositioning.
I will need to think about something. Maybe we'll give him a pistol.
All I need is a clear shot.
Siren is almost down, but almost is not quite down.
Moving to coordinates. Let's get this done.
Ten hit points, bleeds, and things will be okay.
Repositioning.
Moves up.
Yeah. All set.
Good. Enders. Give me that and that and that. And Enders gets a shotgun in return, which means we're at least, Tyler can at least shoot something.
I'm going.
Moving on.
Be right there.
Agent Carl moves on. And appropriate Murphy moves completely on. And Tyler moves on as well.
Already there.
My head. I can't breathe.
Good. This here is a nice shot off. Siren Fury doesn't know what to do. Seems to have been running out of ammunition. I never knew that they could do that.
Ready for action.
But now the name of the game is Rush, Rush, Rush. Rush, Rush, and Rush again.
Moving.
Good.
I'm here.
The green jumps over and reloads his gun. Everybody else just going to run as fast and as far as they can. Boy, what a mission. These hive missions started with an ultra easy
double time
destruction of a few eggs and a couple of like minor things. And they somehow at some point, I don't know when exactly, there was a massive spike, and all of a sudden sirens came. That in itself made it more difficult, but then even worse, like these huge creatures were starting to appear. Recovering more points. I think we can recover here as well. Those with those who are fast, we can very much recover. Overwatch. Asian cow runs. Little green could jump out in one go, which tells me that he needs to recover this turn.
Dashing ahead.
Okay, the only problem is Natalia, our sniper, is not the fastest. And the enemy has a gun, which typically isn't very nice. Because they can engage on range. Alright, Natalia just continues to run away.
No time to waste.
Moving into cover. Unfortunately, we don't have any ammunition left, which is really a shame.
Moving to coordinates.
But we can also jump, so it's not a problem. Tyler could leave in one go. Might as well overwatch. Little green could jump in one go as well, which means now he's going to do the covering here. I'm not overwatching with a shotgun. Good, we're almost there. This guy here could be a problem. So he's overwatching.
Standing
I'm fine
back.
With that. Natalia just runs out. Like I said,
on the move.
Very much can still run out next turn. Tyler goes into cover. Moves out. Moves out.
I'm going.
Moves out.
5x5.
Let's roll.
Moves out.
On it.
Gets out. I'll just wait here with a medkit and potential shouts if needed. for next turn. Alright. The siren changes the ball game, of course, as always.
All set.
No time to waste.
Oh boy, what a mission. It feels like all of these are getting harder and harder. ...600 XP. It didn't feel like we could easily do it with 8 people, although this is the second team. Just way too much firepower from the enemy. And I personally also don't like that you can bring 8 operatives. I really like the maximum of XCOM 2 with 6 operatives. Good, so we have shared research. Poison weapon. First damage point of poison virus acid fire applied per attack is ignored. Okay, well, I think that is a fantastic option. Mist repellent facility available. I think that's even better. So wait, we wanted that order. Okay. Shared research. Good, we have a long research queue now. Team is feeling good after that mission, but I think we need to go back. I don't see how it would add more value just cruising around. Spawner is increased by 20% the damage, that is good. Six, we're trading. We are continuing to trade actively. Oh, I forgot. Move back. Hayden info. We don't have the necessary resource. Well, we can change that in a second. Just need to find the right resources. In the meantime, we're a bit idle up here. I don't like that. Good. The Senate aliens continue to develop. They can now close range attack. Wonderful. And this guy has upgraded to 4,000 hit points. Massive sonic stun effect with a specialized head. No technology here. Okay, so trading, we need a bit more. Frankly, we need a bit more of normal materials. Hayden info. Shit, now we don't have the normal materials. Can't deploy a guardian. Our personnel in Frozen Circuit is still regaining health, so we're okay. We're not wasting time, that's good. Core 1 slowly needs to get to here.
Construction complete.
Trade. We need. No, 249. I'm not going to do that. Again, I don't want to trade 249. What is wrong with you guys? There we go, much better. Why does that haven have... Oh, they are just building that up. Okay, I see. Good, the team in Frozen Circuit is now fully healed and rested. That's good. Personnel, we do have a technician with us. Action point cost for medkits reduced by 1. And we got a deployable turret. Out of curiosity, can we now... reverse engineer that. Requirements not met. Oh, we need 2 of these. Okay. Yeah, sure. But I tell you what. We got a turret now. Good. Frozen Circuit. I think we wanted... Vanessa to wait and we're instead just using the normal team that has now healed up. The question that I'm asking myself is, what are we going to do with that team? Because, again, that's too far away. We can't go there yet. That's too far away. I'm still trying to build up that aircraft here in the USA. And there is no mission other than these ultra hard resource sites. And just going there and losing members of the team doesn't sound like a smart plan. These guys do have missions for us, but that is difficult to obtain. By the way, why are we just hovering at friendly? I thought everybody liked it when I was just destroying the hive. Anyways, we got something over here. So maybe that's our play. Good, we're fighting against the Forsaken. Not sure who they are, I might have forgotten it. Rich site. Recover items from crates. Okay, cool. That's a new one, right? Yeah, it seems to be a richer one. Good. Tiamat is almost back. And I need to get more resources. That's the biggest problem that I'm seeing. Still haven't figured out a good way of doing that. It feels we're stagnating a bit. The few resources that we're getting from Haven Defense are all fine and good, but and trading is also okay, but something's not really clicking yet. Can't yet go here. Just out of curiosity, could we reach that? No, that is too far away. Again, too far away. So we would need to activate the bases. And without bases, we can't reach that. Good. We'll do that next. And I mean, at least the factions hate each other, but they don't seem to be at war at the moment. Could be worse. Everybody's trying to do their own thing. Yeah. So, normal resources exhausted. I'm at least not finding more. And I think the biggest challenge is we need to continue getting experience for our team. And that is, I'm struggling to do that. But maybe it is just because the game is slowing down due to so many things happening. I mean, we've killed all of the hives, right? We've defended everything. There is, by the way, an unexplored site here. So a few new unexplored sites are popping up here and there. But not really anything major. So again, I'm wondering how we're doing business. I could imagine just flying around with a fast aircraft and simply trading the entire time. Maybe that's the way to do it. Building one of these Heliuses. And then being an ultra trader. I could see that. It's even faster than the Manticore. Currently we still need all of our aircrafts, right? We do have three aircrafts and we have three teams that are continuously doing missions. But the missions are now slowing down. Maybe it is just that we defeated the attack wave of the enemies that were coming in. I'm pretty sure the attack that we had here on the Disciples of Anu, or somewhere here, I think it was somewhere here, and then we cleared the hive. It was no coincidence that this main thing was injured. So the game seems to be calculating behind the scenes just effectively the enemy strength, similar like it was in Long War. Good. Yeah, but the main team, for instance, for us, we're now going on to a mission, but it takes so long to just get missions, so unless you want to really start like regularly raiding places, you end up with a limited amount of missions. But then again, potentially just putting people in here and letting them gain experience that way might also be an option, and having a prime team that flies from A to B. Would I play it again? Then I would potentially set it up differently with Helios that can fly around and trade much faster, because the trading is surprisingly efficient. I mean, we've now invested everything into food, right? But if we could get out of food, most of them are producing food, but here, like the ones that are not, that's an efficient route, just going through all of this and basically trading out of food. In terms of research, does any of this here give us a couple more resources, because we could really use that? The answer is no. Another thing is, I saw that you could dismantle stuff. So I'm just wondering, yeah, but at some point we will again need that. So the just scrapping material, I don't think is a smart idea. But I can do that the next time I really need resources, like dismantle something like an independent handgun, right? Okay, cool. Works out well. But yeah, okay, I'll eventually figure out how to get more items. This year should give us good items that we can actually use and or scrap. And yeah, maybe with more preparations I could take the A team to the to all of the ruins. But that would be a dangerous endeavor. On the other hand, getting the runes would help us quite a bit. I wish I could read guides to understand if this here was a fluke, this Protean a mutane field, living crystal quarry. I have no idea. Yeah, maybe after the scavenging site, we're going to just obtain the resources here, and I'm just trying my luck, and we're going to see how that works. Anyways, vision has gone on way too long. I'm just thinking about and strategizing. Thank you so much for watching, guys. If you like the game as much as I do, then leave a comment and a like down below, and see you soon. Bye bye.